Kong, where protesters have been gathered. Operation to shut down the site that had sprawled across a normally busy highway on the edge of Hong Kong's financial district. The student-led demonstrations were protesting Beijing's restrictions on the 2017 election, which will determine the first leader elected from this former British colony, which was handed from British to Chinese control in 1997. The BBC's John Sudworth joins us from Hong Kong. And John, what was it like when police were clearing, these were mostly students, when they were clearing them out?
It was an extraordinary moment. These protests, of course, once looked like they might be able to present China's ruling Communist Party with a real challenge. The first real challenge on the issue of democracy in decades, of course, coming from the streets of Hong Kong. And yet, today, in its final moments, it was all over very quickly. The police, as you say, moved very methodically, very quickly, picking up the tents with heavy lifting equipment, sweeping away the debris and the flotsam and jetsam of protest life, and arresting the few stragglers. 100 or so people sat down on the ground, refusing to leave. They were picked up one by one and carried rather unceremoniously into the waiting police buses.
It also appears that they're promising to return. We're seeing pictures of a huge banner draped across the area saying, "We'll be back."
That's right, "We'll be back." Another one saying, "This is only the beginning." I think, you know, the protesters have to try to see something from the jaws of defeat, of course. And they have a point. This movement, although it hasn't won any of its key aims, it hasn't persuaded Beijing to grant Hong Kong any more democracy, it has brought world attention. It has galvanized a generation here in Hong Kong. But at the same time, you know, this was a protest movement that had already run out of steam. From its peak of tens of thousands of people, in the last few weeks we've just seen a few hundred. And it's not force today that's brought these protests to an end, but fatigue, a sense of futility in the face of Beijing's reluctance. Intransigence, a sense that they weren't getting what they wanted, and numbers have just simply drifted away.
Well, tell us more about what the students wanted. Yes, they wanted to be able to have free and clear elections. The sense is that in 2017, it's going to be a Beijing-picked candidate that's going to lead the country. But what else did they want?
The historical context, of course, is that Hong Kong has never had much democracy, and when it was handed over from British rule to the Chinese, the deal was that China would introduce Hong Kong's first ever fully democratic elections. They will take place in 2017. They will be the first elections in which every citizen in Hong Kong gets to vote. But Beijing has insisted on retaining this power of veto, if you like. The candidates are chosen by a nominating committee, not by public nomination, which gives the Communist Party the ability to make sure those who are unfriendly to Chinese rule, for example, don't get to stand. And that's what the protesters have been objecting to. And as I say, at the beginning, when there was this extraordinary moment, as tens of thousands came onto the streets, there was a sense that maybe, just maybe, this was going to present China with the kind of challenge that it would have to listen to. In the end, it's given them nothing, and it's won the day.
Well, we understand some of these younger protests were also angry about a lack of opportunity, the wealth gap in their country. But what about others in Hong Kong? These young protesters are vowing, they were chanting, "We will be back." Will they? I mean, will they have the support, or is there a sense for maybe a different generation there in Hong Kong? Look, you tried, it's over.
I think that is a fair observation. This was always a divided thing.
Thank you. 目的じゃないか、これはなかったんですけど、ちょっと。